magical child was born. But there's more to the story than anyone really knows.
Oh yes, it's the greatest story never told. And tonight, we'll hear from those who were there.
On that night, when Christ was born.
Where the blessed child first showed his face to the light. What's happening there tonight?
Who lives there now that the child is gone? Why, the ones that were there on that night, filled with blood, a donkey.
Feliz Navidad.
A sheep.
Feliz Navidad.
The only thing that could save them now was a miracle. But where does one find a miracle on a deserted country road to Bethlehem? Yeah, baby! And that's when I came to the rescue!
Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by.
Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light.
The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight.
The donkey gave him a lift and a gift. He lent a helping hand to people in need. And it's that spirit of giving that is at the heart of our Christmas story. And it starts softly.
If you recall, there was only one inn open in Bethlehem that night. and they had no room left.
Away in a manger, no room at the inn. A child is made for life to begin.
Honey, I finished feeding the animals.
Did you walk up?
I'm hanging up the key to the barn right now.
Well, turn down that lamp before you come to bed. Our oil bills are going through the roof. I was trying to build a nest that night, and I was looking for things to build it with, when something shiny caught my eye.
Excuse me.
Oh, hello. Reservations? Vacation club?
No. But we'd like a room for the night.
Sorry, we're all booked.
Well, is there another inn nearby?
There's the Best Middle Eastern and the Holy Day Inn, but they're full up tonight.
Where are we going to stay?
The attic's full of boxes. Wait a minute. We've got a barn out back. You're welcome to sleep there. At least we'll be out of the snow.
Well,
have a little faith.
All right.
Great! Follow me, and don't worry. We'll leave the light on for you.
Away in a manger, no crib for his bed. The little boy Jesus laid down his sweet head. He gave me Lord Jesus, I ask thee to stay. The mighty forever in love me, I pray. Bless all the dear children in thy tender care, and take us to heaven
to so the dove got a place for the night. And so did Mary and Joseph. By taking that room, they showed us how having a little faith in the unexpected can lead to unexpected blessings. Ones that even a mother couldn't have predicted.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy could kiss like to the blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby
stories.
from fate unexpected came blessings untold.
Amazing that anyone would actually believe such nonsense.
What are you talking about?
What are you talking about? Imagine a donkey and a doll trying to take credit for the birth of the child. Everyone knows it was the sheep who was responsible. You may have brought Mary and Joseph to the inn, and by offering that key, you may have put them in the barn. But I'm the reason that child was born inside that manger.
You are?
Absolutely. You see, it was freezing when Mary and Joseph arrived. There wasn't even a small fire to keep them warm. Now, there's nothing easy about having a baby in a barn. The one thing when your child grows up and leaves the door open, you can't say, "Excuse me, were you born in a barn?" And that night, the wind was howling. The air was bitter cold. But Joseph tried to help.
Here, put this one on you.
It's too cold. This blanket won't keep the baby warm enough. The child will be here soon, Joseph. What are we going to do?
You heard the innkeeper. There's no other place for us to go.
But how can we possibly stay here? Had they gone back out into the snow, they would have surely perished. That's why I, the sheep, came over and saved Mary and the baby.
This wool, it's so soft and warm.
Went to Bethlehem, they came and knew not where to stay. They felt the warmth and kindness of sheep that feed on hay.
Here, Mary, gently and to the Lord did pray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy.
Oh yeah, Jenny wants it, huh?
You want to know who to thank for it happening here? That's right, me! Think about that the next time you're ordering lamb chops!
Wow, I can't believe it! You are the reason that the child was born in this venture!
Oh, please! Mary and Joseph would have never come into the barn if it wasn't for me!
So, they wouldn't have made it to Bethlehem if it weren't for me! Fighting to take credit.
Oh, great. Now we're gonna find out it was a camel who saved the child.
Quiet. None of you did anything by yourselves. You all three helped. And that is why you are all three important.
He's right. We shouldn't be trying to take credit like this. After all, you're important. And you're important. And me? I'm the most important because I brought all the children to Bethlehem.
In case you didn't notice, there were others here that night who also welcomed the child.
That's right! There were angels, remember? And I'm the one who spotted them. I said, hey, look! There's angels right up on...
I'm not talking about angels.
Wait a minute. Are you saying that you were here too?
My two brothers and I brought wise men from afar, bearing gifts.
I could have seen it.
It's not so hard to see it. Just open your heart. Because every time you help someone in need, or have faith in the unexpected, or give comfort to a stranger, you are sharing the spirit of Christmas.
And you'll see it right away. A sight so astonishing, you'll never forget! Can you do that?